Hello, everyone. I'm Savine Reddy, a group program manager in Microsoft's big data team, and I'm going to show you how easy it is to be productive as a developer with Azure Data Lake. Now, Azure Data Lake has great integration with Visual Studio. We not only have IntelliSense, we can also let you extend USQL with C# code behind, submit and monitor those jobs, and most importantly, we've made debugging your code, executing in a distributed framework, amazingly simple. And this is what we're going to show in the demo. So what we're looking at here is Azure Data Lake tools for Visual Studio inside of Visual Studio 2015. I have a simple USQL script up. As you can see, I have declared a row set called A, which is just two tweets. And I've declared a row set called B, which selects a single column for row set A. And I output that as a CSV file. Now, you can see here, as I hit the dot symbol, that full IntelliSense is supported because the USQL types are the C# or .NET types, right? So I can do two upper as some column. Now, what if I have something that's more complex than that? And I want not just a simple little C# expression, but I need to put it into a bigger method. We have a code behind file, and I'll show you that file. And I've pre-created a function called normalize author. And in this case, I've designed this thing to trim a string and make it uppercase. And in addition, I've actually created a simple deliberate error in this. So we're going to use this to debug a problem during script execution. Let's close this and paste in this code. Now, as you can see, the code I have in the code behind can immediately be accessed by the USQL without any uploading, any registration. It all just works seamlessly. So if I hit submit, this script will run. Now, and as I mentioned before, the script is designed to fail because this is the next step. Not only have you made this simple with IntelliSense and this code behind C# editing, we've also made it simple to debug a job. Let's take a look at a job that I ran previously. And this is the same script. And you can see that it's actually failed. And of course, we know the reason why. But let's see what happens, how we can investigate this issue. Because this code ran in a cluster that you don't have access to. So how do we make debugging simple? We'll click on this job. We'll click open. And then what's interesting, here's a new instance of Visual Studio will launch. In this case, in fact, Visual Studio 2017. And the very piece of code that failed in our cluster will be downloaded. That means the code you wrote, the USQL code, our USQL runtime, as well as any C# code. Okay. And as soon as Visual Studio 2017 launches, you will see a new project that's automatically being created, which is called, in this case, automatically ADL tool, code behind debugging. Now, as any .NET developer would, when we get a solution, a project, and someone tells us, hey, there's an error, an exception's being thrown, what's our first instinct? You know, start debugging the project. So without any further configuration of the system or the tooling or configuring our Azure service, let's just start debugging and see if we can find the error. So I clicked start, and what's happening is the script is being compiled, the full USQL runtime is running it in the context of Visual Studio debugging, and let's see if it, and look at there. We've actually, the breakpoint has been thrown exactly on the line of code that failed. And even though this code was all run in a distributed environment in the cloud, our debugging is now seamless, just as you would expect within Visual Studio. Wasn't that amazing? If you're a .NET developer, this is exactly what you'd imagine debugging should be in the cloud, all made possible through the tight integration of Azure Data Lake Analytics, USQL, and Visual Studio. For more, go to aka.ms/AzureDataLake and find out everything you need to know to get started now.